More You Talk Now.
Hey everyone, this is Larissa with Katie Ann.
Hi.
How's it going, Katie?
It's good. It's been going, you know, we're still, some people have told me they have nothing to do, and I'm just like, I'm more busy now than I was, and I'm like, how is that even possible? Like, how do you have nothing to do? I don't know. I guess it's just different people's, what they do.
I have a question for you. Be honest, all right? Like, are you binge watching anything? Like, even though you're busy, like, do you take time out for yourself and go like, hey, I'm going to take a break right now and do something else?
I do. So on the weekends is like my binge time. So I watch, you know, an episode a night on the weekends. And it's hard not to binge watch when you find a good show. I actually watched a movie a couple nights ago. And it was an older movie, but I'd never seen it. And it was called The Ghost of Girlfriend's Past.
Oh, yeah.
It was a modern take on the Christmas Carol and Scrooge.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. The guy was like visited by girlfriends of his past to show him, you know, why he needed to change toward women. And it was actually quite funny. It was old, but I had just discovered it, you know, just flipping through Netflix trying to find something to watch.
Yeah. Well, that sounds like one of those like guilty pleasures that you have.
Yes.
So the show that I've been binge watching or at least catching up on is Legends of Tomorrow. I don't know if you're into that, the whole DC Arrowverse superhero, but Legends of Tomorrow is just like one of the wackiest shows. It's a really well-written show, but it's so bizarre because they time travel and they have a lot of just, yeah, wacky pop culture references. And it's like a superhero show on like steroids, but it's also like a comedy. And so it's probably the funniest superhero show out there right now. So
I have not checked it out yet, but I will have to check one out. I see all of them like on the WB and stuff, and the CW, I guess it's the CW now, not the WB. And like, I'm like, oh, I should, you know, I should look that up on Netflix, or I should look that up and, you know, start watching it. I just never have. I'll see parts of the episode. So.
And we have a very special guest that's about to join us in a minute.
Yeah.
Our good friend, Robert Eibach, amazing remixer, DJ, always has good curly hair. And you
know. Always talking about food since the quarantine started. You guys have to go check out his page because he's always posting hilarious photos about how he's thinking about food. But I think we should bring Robert on.
We should. Okay. We'll see you later, Katie.
Yes. Bye.
So, Robert Eibach, if you don't know him, you should know him. He has worked with a lot of major artists. You know, you may have heard of them, Ariana Grande, Selena Gomez. He's just done a few remixes. Larissa Lamb, I don't know if that rings a bell. April Diamond, David Longoria. But Robert.
Hey, I'm
yay.
Here.
Hey. Hi.
Hi.
Haven't seen you in forever.
I know, right?
I totally miss hanging out with you in the studio and, you know.
Likewise. I know. It's been wild the past few months here.
I'm sure. Well, so catch us up a little bit. Like, what have you been doing during this quarantine?
Eating. No. No, you know what? It's been a good opportunity to get caught up on a lot of stuff, you know, and just caught up on a lot of music, write a lot, and, you know, listen to new music. It's, you know, it is funny how something like this can lead you to like a phase where you don't want to do anything at all. But at the same time, it's something that, as you know, as a songwriter, you know, it's like we could find things to write about anytime, you know, whether there's a pandemic or not. But it's definitely like a chill time where you can just kind of just really sit and take advantage of the extra time.
No, definitely. I know we've been working on a new song like forever. And so during this downtime, I got to get to it and start working on some new music as well. So I know you don't like to like brag or anything. I named a couple of artists, but like, what were the most recent remixes that you've done in the last few months, whether it's during or prior to the pandemic?
The ones that came out or not?
Yeah, the ones that actually you can talk about.
Recently just hit number one with J-Lo on Billboard.
Oh, I heard she was some dancer on some show.
Yeah, I think it was the Super Bowl. It must have been like this big bowl of Doritos or something. No, oh yeah, she's a fly girl, huh?
She was on Olympic Color.
Yeah.
But yeah, she just did a big show. Yeah, the Super Bowl of all things. Yeah.
Yeah, so I remixed her. Let me think. That's actually a tough question because I have to think of who I did remix recently.
Well, that's a good one to name drop. Yeah.
I kind of feel like there was was one after her, though, that I'm not remembering. I'm sorry.
I don't know about you, but, like, during this whole pandemic, I feel like time is just completely blurred. Mm-hmm. You know, you have no idea, like, what day of the week it is, like, mm-hmm. what time of day it is, and everything is just starting to, you know, all mush together.
Mm-hmm. No, so. No, it's been funny. And even on, like, the Billboard charts and stuff, they're frozen right now, or, like, suspended for the time being, because, you know, there's no one's going out. So it's just funny because it's like, it's literally frozen in time.
Yeah. It's bizarre. Like, even like movie theaters, you know, and concert venues, I just heard like Greek theater, you know, out in LA just canceled their whole season. And so, you know, what do you look forward to, I guess, moving forward? Like, what, you know, what do you see yourself doing in the next few months? I mean, I know we don't know what's going to happen, but what do you have planned so far?
Going to an actual restaurant, that would be awesome. we've been talking about some things with David Longoria, who, you know, we're planning some different surprises for everybody to see, you know, whether it's a live thing like this through the internet, or, you know, it might be something different. I don't know how much I'm allowed to talk about, but but no, I think, you know, I think you're aware of a couple things, and I do think it's kind of cool that we can do things like this now. And it's funny how the pandemic has led to people communicating more with each other who hadn't, like, talked to each other. And it's like, you know, mm-hmm. we've always had Instagram Live. We've always had,
right.
you know, FaceTime and those things. But for some reason, this has caused people to communicate with each other more, which, I mean, I guess that's kind of a silver lining to
yeah.
it all. But
I know, that is one of the things. I talked to my old college roommates, like, the other day, and it was always so hard to get all four of us, like, on the phone at the same time, or we try to do, like, a vacation, so that was kind of fun to do a video call with all of them. So for you, you know, what is your biggest challenge right now, like, during this whole thing?
The biggest challenge is not knowing what's going to happen next, you know, like, you probably understand this a lot, because you guys have been traveling a lot, so you don't know what venues are going to be open, and what they're going to allow, and different things like that. And then also, like I was saying, with the different charts, everything's changing, so it's kind of like understanding how to follow those changes and adapt to what's happening. So I think that's kind of like a big thing, is that there's just so many unknowns. But the good thing is that with music, we can just continue to make music, and however that music gets out there, that's, I don't want to say the easy part, but that's the part that's, it doesn't change how we create in what we do. You know what I mean?
Right. I mean, the good thing is people can listen to music from home. They can listen to it, you know, anywhere they go. The only thing that changes is, like, if you get to see a live concert, but now it's just going online. It's not quite the same.
I was, like, seeing someone was, like, talking about it. I think it was, like, Dua Lipa, and she was talking about how, she's like, you know what, doing these Zoom concerts are actually pretty hard, because you don't know what each person's internet connection is. So when you have a band here, and then someone in Chicago, and then someone in New York, you don't know if they're playing off of a delay or off of each other, like, in real time. So so I think that's been kind of a challenging thing, but it's also adapted us as performers and how to do things differently, because you never know what's going to happen, and to be prepared to, it's great that technology has evolved to what it has become to be able to do things like that in this.
Oh, totally. You know, if this pandemic had happened like 15 years ago, like, it would have been so, so different, you know, different time for sure. Yeah. So
we'd be on MySpace and talking about our top eight.
You'd have like a flip phone. Is that what they had back then? Right, like a flip phone before we had the smartphones, right?
I'm not that old.
I know. I saw it on like a TV show the other day where I saw like, or, you know, oh, they had a flip phone. Yep. What were those? You know? So one thing we want to ask you too is, you know, we might have some aspiring DJs or remixers out there. How did you get your start? And, you know, what advice would you give to somebody who's looking to go down that road and be the next Robert Eibach?
Good question. I think how I got started was David, who, you know, I had always kind of done it, like dabbled in it a little bit. And some artists on our label, you in particular, were releasing some records. And he was getting some remixers involved. And I said, you know what, I'm going to take a stab at this. So I did a few of them, and it kind of snowballed from there. But I think as far as anyone who's trying to get into it, this is a great time to do it. For one, we have a lot of time on our hands, so why not? There's no excuse to get in there if you really want to do something. And technology is so readily available. I mean, there's so many websites where you can buy some samples from and different things where you can, you know, really refine your craft. They weren't even around, you know, even 2, 3, 4 years ago. And, you know, I think everybody's computer comes with software now where you can do things. So I think it's a matter of, like, really just diving in and taking advantage of the time that you have and take advantage of all the equipment that's at your fingertips. I even get messages, you know, people want to send, oh, like, can you give me some advice? Can you, any tips on what to do? And there's so many people that are willing to give their opinions and to help other people along, you know, and I think that's what's great about social media too, is that you can ask anyone, you know, and most people are going to answer you and say, oh yeah, you know, do this, you know, that's cool, you know, whatever.
That's some good advice, because there are, like, a lot of apps. There's a lot of different things that you can do now to kind of just start making music, really, mm-hmm. and start mixing things. Okay, so another thing we wanted to talk to you about is we have a thing going on at Utalk that is called the hashtag goodbye to mean challenge that we're doing. Mm-hmm. And so we would like you, Robert, to take this challenge. And all you have to do is in the next couple days, post something that you've done to kind of counter some of the meanness. You know, sometimes social media cannot be as nice as people asking for advice. Some people can be trolling, you know. What's, like, the worst, like, comment somebody's ever made to you?
You know, I actually am kind of lucky in the sense that I don't get too many. Oh, you know, I did a remix for an artist, and this artist has, like, some, like, very hardcore fans, and some of her fans were saying, you ruined the original song. How dare you speed it up? How dare you do those things? Like, chill, you know, the label asked me to do that, so it's all good. I didn't ruin the song, but I think that would be kind of, like, the meanest. I've been lucky enough, and I think honestly that females have it a lot worse, where you'll get, like, a lot more meanness, so to speak, from other people than guys will. But that's probably it. Like, people will pick on the they'll say just some funny things, and I just try and laugh it off, you know. It's like, well, you know.
Okay, yeah, so, I know. Well, you know, so what you can do as part of our goodbye to mean challenge is, you know, maybe post something you've done to counter the meanness with kindness, mm-hmm. or leave a kind comment on someone's post, or do something nice for somebody, you know, that's around you. I mean, I think you live by yourself, so you don't have anybody mm-hmm. to do something nice to. But it doesn't have to be physically. Maybe you're doing some other gesture. And we want you to post a picture or video of your act of kindness and then hashtag it goodbye to the number two, mean. Mm. So are you in, Robert?
I'm always in.
Okay, he is in for our goodbye to mean challenge. And those of you out there who are watching, you guys can do the same challenge too. If you want to post something that's kind, an act of kindness that you've seen or something that you've done, and hashtag it goodbye to mean. We want to hear from you guys as well. I know you're doing a ton of stuff, you know, at home and eating a lot and dreaming about the days you can go to a restaurant. I'm sure you've got a mental list, like all of us do, of, like, all the things and places you want to go, like, as soon as all the restrictions are lifted. How can people keep in touch with you? Where can they find more out?
Which is funny, because this is the only one that's different than all the other ones, but everywhere it's just at Robert, R-O-B-E-R-T. Eibach, E-I-B-A-C-H, everything other than Instagram. So it's pretty easy. What's funny is that I tried to get my name on Instagram and they would not allow it.
So. Yeah, somebody else has Larissa Lamb, so I'm Larissa Lamb Music, and it's kind of the anomaly as well. Mm. But I'm also finding that there's other Larissa Lambs that are now getting, like, the TikToks and the other accounts before me. So then I'm like, oh, I have to keep being Larissa Lamb Music now. So, but that's life, right? And for people who are tuning in, we are with Robert Eibach, world-class, renowned remixer, DJ, nice guy all around, friend to furry woodland creatures. I don't know. I'm just, like, making stuff up now about you. We've had a really great chat. You know, our show is all about you talking to us right now. You are the Robert, but we love getting and hearing all sorts of comments and questions from our audience. So I want to remind everybody, if you have a question about anything in life, maybe you're struggling with something during this quarantine, please reach out to us. You can DM us on Instagram. You can also reach us on our other socials. Utalk Radio does have it across the board. So Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, it's all Utalk Radio. And you can also text us at Utalk to 411. Sorry, text the word Utalk to 411-247. If you got a question, you got a comment, and of course, find out more about us at utalkradio.com. Okay, so earlier we talked with Kati about what she was like binge watching. I shared about what I was binge watching. So Robert, what have you been binge watching lately?
Okay, this one's funny. So I've watched every single Marvel movie that I haven't seen. I haven't, you know, the ones that I had seen were just pretty much the Iron Man ones. So now I've seen every single one of the Marvel movies.
Did you see them in their original order of release, or did you see them chronologically according to where they fall in the actual chronological timeline?
I watched them based on my interest, and then I had to watch some of the other ones because I was like, wait, who? Who's that? But no, unfortunately, I didn't watch them in the order, but I did cheat a little bit, and I went on to IMDb and like looked at their list and how they had them in order and who was who. So I was, okay, so I kind of understood where everyone was, but I just finished Endgame yesterday.
Okay, so you did end with Endgame.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, I did. I ended with Infinity Wars into Endgame. So.
Okay, cool. Mm-hmm. I had friends who had never seen any of the Marvel movies, and they asked me, it's like, oh, can we just watch Infinity, you know, Wars and Endgame? And I'm like, might be very confusing if you don't watch at least a few of the other movies beforehand.
At least one of each of the ones. So like one Iron Man, one Guardians of the Galaxy, like one Captain America. You'll kind of get it from that. But
right. I kind of told people, it's like, yeah, watch the original Iron Man. Definitely all the Captain Americas. You know, those were like sort of Winter Soldier, you know, Civil War. Like those are kind of critical. Right, and then leading up to the few movies leading up to, you know, the Avengers saga. Mm-hmm. I mean, all the other Avengers movies.
Yeah, no, actually, that's actually pretty good. You should watch the Avengers ones. And Guardians. I really thought, like, Guardians of the Galaxy was, like, that's pretty important to the whole story, too, to, like, understand those characters.
I know the longer we talk, we're basically like, Black Panther was important. Ant-Man was important.
Doctor Strange.
Strange was important. And you're like, and everyone's like,
Captain
I know.
Marvel, that's
I know, exactly. So, no, I'm right there with you. We sound super nerdy right now, but, you know. But that's
actually
what's fun.
I think I have one of them. Yeah, the first Avengers is on right now.
Katie says, like, movie night for all of us after quarantine. That's right.
You know what? Like, my friends are, like, been doing a Zoom movie night where they're all, like,
like a watch party.
Same movie. Yeah.
And there's different apps that, like, there's one, like, called Cast and a few others, like, where you could do that. There's, like, and you can chat at the same time and watch, you know, all the same thing. So, but we really appreciate you stopping by Utalk today. And don't forget to check out all of Robert's remixes, most of them, which you can find on Spotify and YouTube and all that. You know, we'll talk to you again soon. And hopefully we'll actually see each other in person sooner than later. Because it's kind of weird that we just see each other virtually, but at least it's better than nothing. So thanks everyone for joining us. Bye.
This is Utalk Radio.